therapy options for patients with acute ischemic stroke are obviously intravenous thrombolysis that has been practiced for a long time now. But recently, there have been several studies that have very convincingly shown that if you add mechanical thrombectomy to patients that suffer from a large vessel occlusion, the outcome is absolutely superior.
It is very obvious that Mr. Clean and the other big randomized trials have revolutionized treatment of acute ischemic stroke. It has been clearly shown that revascularization for the patient with ischemic stroke in a certain time window gives a far better outcome compared to conservative treatment. The main criteria for patient selection are based on first history, clinical situation, and on the status of the intracranial arteries. It has been shown that despite a high revascularization rate between 80 and 90%, we see a clear clinical benefit in only up to 60% of our patients. That means that we perform futile interventions in about 20 to 30% of the patients. And it will be the task of further studies to really define parameters which tell us which patient will benefit most from our procedure.
The future for stroke therapy will depend on having a multidisciplinary approach. And this means we have clear guidelines as to how patients are going to be imaged, how patients are going to be triaged to have treatment for stroke, how the procedures are going to be carried out, and then subsequent to that, how the patients are going to be managed, followed up, and any subsequent anti-stroke, anti-platelet therapies and medical management.
Everyone has its role. And I think this is very, very important because you have to gain time. You have to work fast. So by doing this, you can cut times tremendously. This being said, it's very important that the neurointerventionalist takes full responsibility for the clinical part, I would say, because if you treat the patient, if you actually operate on a patient, of course you should see him or her before, you should see him or her after, and in follow-up.
Currently, there are not enough trained interventional radiologists to provide cover uniformly across all areas. This will require a massive increase in investment in training of interventional radiologists so that there are sufficient numbers. So one of the biggest challenges for providing 24/7 stroke care is having the appropriate infrastructure in all parts of the European Union and in the UK.